Let's see. Got a mixture of concentrated simple greens, some spray nine, and threw in the bulk of the big parts. I still have the small parts. This thing just, it comes with a small little tea bag sort of thing that's too small for the small bit. So just gonna put it in there. It's heating up right now. I was gonna get the 10 liter one, and then I saw this on sale. It was actually 20 bucks less. This is the 15 liter. And I thought it would be deeper than this. It's still just enough to cover the carburetors. It still hasn't, like I said, it still hasn't heated up yet. I'm gonna have to put some more water in there, but it's just a mixture of water, simple green, and I guess spray nine. Okay, I'm pulling parts out of the ultrasonic cleaner. Opened it up without realizing I wasn't recording, so. Yeah, huge difference. This is the just a couple of parts here. I don't know if you can tell or not, but that's a, compared to what it was, that's a big, big change. Anyway, I'm gonna keep opening all these things up. I'll just put the camera there. So that's the ultrasonic cleaner after a 20 minute cycle. It's still warming up, but it takes a long time to warm up. I'll pull the parts out and we'll have a look. I can still see a little bit of carbon, not very much. I'm gonna open this up, have a look. Yeah, definitely still needs to go in there a little bit longer, but inside the choke circuit, I'm looking, and there's absolutely no carbon. There's no soot, there's no dirt anywhere, and all the brass looks really shiny. So I'm gonna put that in again. So I'll figure out what I'm gonna do with that, and then once I figure something out, I will record it and take it from there. But all this stuff, the hose is spotless. There's no residue on that at all. It looks brand new. This part is the linkage that holds two carbs together on the top. This is the choke linkage. This looks like a brand new part. These are the springs. They were covered in carbon, and I didn't think they were going to clean up, but again, they look brand new. So I'll leave it at that, and yeah, back to the float bowls. So yeah, the float bowls look, again, it looks like they look like brand new parts, which is wonderful. So I'm done with these. I'm gonna spray them in WD-40, just like I said, just to displace the water. Obviously aluminum is not gonna rust, but I just don't want, you know, a little bit of lubrication just to get it started, and just like I said, just to keep the dirt away. But these were the caps. Obviously these caps came out virtually spotless, just almost like new. Can't believe that. Yeah, so that's that. So like I said, still have the little parts to do. We'll get on that in a little bit. Okay, so this is the carbs out of the ultrasonic cleaner. They're pretty hot actually. I'm just gonna blow them off. Alright, for the first time I can actually see light through the pilot mixture screw, and that's a tiny little hole that comes out in front of the butterfly valves. They look brand new actually. These are 37 years old. Okay, so to make sure the water is displaced, I'm just gonna coat these things and WD-40, and I'll start off with the jets. Of course, when I do put this together, I
I'll blow it out again. I'm just not ready to assemble everything. Just got a light coating of oil on it. Light oil just to get all the springs and everything lubricated as well. Of course, I'll blow this all off, and it'll burn off anyway the minute I get it all together and run the thing. I just wanted to make sure that there's... Yeah, it makes a big difference just in the way that the throttles open up, just because there's a little bit of oil on the springs now. And that's good for now. Close up. So yeah, they cleaned up really nicely. And for now, like I said, all the soot's gone, all the carbon's gone, even inside the hard to reach places. Next thing on the list is all the little bits. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna basically put this inside and bring the level up, and then put a cover on it, and then throw it back in the tank and run it for a while. I'm going to keep an eye obviously on these floats, but everything else can go in there for as long as it needs, and we'll see how that works. The moment of truth. Choke, which is pretty hard to clean. Quite a difference. These are all the springs. It's the choke spring circuit. That is a spring for this. I'll just leave that out. So yeah, so all the screws came out really nice. That's the pin for the choke and the clips. So they look really nice. Same as the other ones. It's exactly the same thing. The main nozzle, also known as the emulsion tube. I'll blow all this out and coat it with a little bit of WD-40, and then of course before assembly I'll blow everything off, make sure it's clean. Showed you the spring already. I'll blow this out and get all the WD-40 off it, and it should just have a very, almost like a very, very thin layer of oil, just to keep it from, there's any water or moisture attaching to it. And then I'll start putting the carb kits in and getting this thing back together. Alrighty. We have success with the ultrasonic cleaner, I think, anyway. It did a pretty good job on the carbs. So I got the rebuild kits out, ready to go in. I guess the first thing to do is, I got everything on the right. I'm gonna keep the carburetors sort of oriented, so when I turn them like this a couple times and got myself all messed up, but we're gonna pull these kits apart and start putting these together. The left side feeds the number one cylinder, which is the one in the back, and its jet is 124 coupled with the Y34 pin that goes in the bottom of the little diaphragm, the little slider. So just a good example of how well the choke came out. Now it's tarnished, but it's clean. Like it was sooty before, and when you went to pull on it, there was a little bit of grit and grime, and you could feel it. But it's really smooth now. All right. So we'll roll the carburetors over again. I'm just going to keep them in this orientation, and choke goes in, and of course the choke circuit will have to be installed as well. I'm probably not going to do that on camera, no point. Again, when you watch I'll break this down into a couple of videos, but if you watched the first one, you'll see that I had quite a bit of trouble getting this stuff off, and it doesn't need to be that way. These, of course, there's different alloys, different there's different alloys of brass. Some are softer than others. The choke circuit, I can tell it's by touching it. It's got a little bit more substance to it. But it's a different alloy from the jets, let's say. And, you know, but still, it's a soft metal. This is cast aluminum. Just by pulling the carburetors out, you can scratch the fins and scratch the float bowls, which there's evidence of it. Hopefully it wasn't me, but you can see how easy this stuff, you know, how easy it can get damaged. So I don't have a torque spec for this, but I can imagine it's not that much. There's, like I said, it's, I'll have a look at it, but I'm gonna put these things together. So we'll open up the, waiting for this for a while. This thing, like I said, it's been running pretty rough. So what I'm gonna do is I'll open up this, and there's also a piece in here. I don't even know what that is, but I'm gonna put the parts that I don't need away. And of course, I'm looking for the 124. I don't want the other one. So if I can find my little magnifying glass here, there we go. There's two jets that come with each kit. So all you're gonna do is pick one and put the other one away. So this is 132. So that's gonna go in the package with that other thing. And then the other carburetor is gonna be over here. That's the left, 124. The right, it's gonna be 132. So we'll empty that. And if you know what this is, it's a very, very light piece of aluminum. Let me know, please. So I'm looking for 132 on the side. Well, I guess I didn't have to take it out, but that's a 124. So that's the one I don't want. So just because I have that one in there, I'm going to make sure this is a 132. And it is. Float gasket. Four screws. A Y32 pin, which I'll verify here in a moment. Oh yeah, that was a 33 is what that ended up being. That's right. And this one should be a 34. Yeah, it is. So everything on the left. And that should be the whole bottom end of the carburetors right there. So I just made a note of that difference. But yeah. Okay. So I've got the little sliders up here. I got a light coating of oil on them too, just to keep any moisture off them. So definitely got a right and left there. Floats. Believe these are interchangeable. Oh yeah, you can have a good look at the floats. These came out pretty good. They just floated like this in the ultrasonic cleaner. They came out really well. All that, I don't know, it's not mold. It looked like mold, but whatever it was. And I'm just gonna blow these out real quick. Everything needs to be clean, so clean. These openings in these carburetors are so tiny that, you know, the smallest little bit of dirt, you know, rust from your tank, it'll make its way through the fuel system. It'll go right through the lines, obviously. It'll go right through the fuel filter sometimes, so if it's small enough. So first thing I'm going to do is, and I think it's a 10 mil, or no, it's an Allen key. All right, this is a 6 mil Allen key. And this is the pin and the spring that go together like this. That's going to go in there. And that'll go down through the... Put it in right. make sure you get that spring in there properly. And again, it'll be a very gentle thread in. And doesn't have to be tight, just snug it up. And you'll be able to feel a little bit of wobble in that pin. It just has to be able to move around a little bit. So just turn it. And you'll feel where it's in the right spot. I'm just going to push these over and store them inverted. Now, same thing with the left. I think the first thing I should do is put this. This was a culprit for me, so I'm going to pull this apart and get this installed. Okay, so the order that these go in, and again, this was not set up properly on mine, was the O-ring, the spring, and the spring protects, the O-ring washer, and of course that washer protects the O-ring from the spring. And then before we put that in, I have some silicone lubricant, and all I'm going to do is just the tiniest little spray, and that really, really helps with rubber. So now that we have a little bit of silicone lubricant on there, I'm just going to hold up my hand. Right, these don't matter, and I'm just going to thread it in the where it belongs in the pilot. This is the pilot screw. This is a screw that manages your mixture for the start and at idle. This is the one that on a lot of bikes in the US it's blocked off. So I can feel it starting to go in there now. So this is the one where you adjust it by back. It's fuel jet, so it can go in all the way until it's snug, and then you back it off. So I'm going to back it off quite a bit. I just want to make sure that it goes in all the way. Same thing with the second one. Same thing with this one. Don't lose these parts. Put them in the right order. A little bit of that. And then, same thing. These definitely go in there so much nicer than the way they came out. I'll set those later. So, here they are. Right there. So that's the right side. Back to the right side. Let's put the main jets in. So they're gonna go this way. You're gonna hold them in. It'd be nice if you could just sort of drop them in, but you can't. So you gotta kind of feed them in from the top. And slide them in like that. Once you get them in, you'll see where they fit in there. It's a pretty precise fit. When you flip them over, finger underneath, because if you don't, they'll drop. There's no orientation to these, so don't worry about that. And this is the 132 jet. Yeah. And it'll have a washer. Thing is, these kits do not come with washer, which is kind of strange. I cleaned that one up in the bath, but it's not going to have any effect on the jet. All right, that's good. Now that's really all you need. You just need a little bit of pressure. It doesn't need to be sit in there with a torque wrench. That is it. Okay. We're getting there. Now, the kits don't include the crush washer for the main jets, strangely enough. They have the crush washer for the seat. There's definitely a way to these. The rounded edge goes against the face of the seat, the jet seat, or the needle seat. Again, brass on aluminum with an aluminum crush washer. You can only imagine it doesn't take very much torque, just a little scooch like that, that's it. Very, 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 just enough to snug it down. You can feel the pressure of the brass against the aluminum washer. So that's that one. Let's get rid of some more parts here. I'm gonna take the float bowl, and there's a drain screw. It came with a new drain screw, that's nice. So I'll put that in now. These have all been cleaned, the ultrasonic cleaner. All the corrosion that was inside, I took it out with a Dremel tool and a little wire brush. Doesn't take much. Again, you don't torque down on these things. It's just soft brass on a soft aluminum. All right, I'll get the other float bowl out. Same thing with this one. This one was cleaned up, looks pretty good. And trial fit the pin. And this one, as you can see, goes right in, right out, which is nice. This one had a little corrosion on it, and I can't remember if I cleaned it up or not, but yeah, so straight in and straight out. Don't worry about it on these carbs, and I'll tell you why. There's a lot of carbs that have this feature, and I'll do this one, the right one. So I don't know if you can see the casting or not. The carburetor bowl fits on like this. And when you do, just notice the shape of the casting. And it's got, so when this is in here, that's holding the float mechanism up. The minute you put this float bowl on, that pin can't slide back and forth anymore. And even when you open it up, you may find it off to one side or something like that, but it's not going to go far. It doesn't come out. The tolerances are close enough that, you know, if you move it, you can actually hear it hitting the sides of the float bowl. Cool. That's that. Float pin with a spring. Floats. Now, here's something you also want to check when you're putting this all back together again. These floats literally should be, there should be no, like if you hold it up, you have to push it down. In other words, you're working against friction, and that friction is going to be corrosion, dirt, pin's going to be bent, it's going to be crushed somehow in here, or it's the wrong one if you bought replacement parts. But in any case, it should be that easy, right? So that's how this goes together. So that's going to fit in there like that. Pin's going to go through there, and this is going to hang in here like so. It's going to go in there. You can actually push just a little bit, you can feel that spring inside the float pin. Now, I'm just going to look at these and compare them to the way the old ones were, and it's sitting exactly the way the other ones were. So I'm going to hope that that's the right way to have them, because it's really is, you want to talk about a royal pain, setting the float height. And the tolerance is, I think, plus or minus a millimeter. But what you do with these is there's some carburetors where you measure or you set them a certain way distance from the bottom of the float bowl. In this particular model, Yamaha calls out that you actually have to put the thing together. You can do it on the bench just as easily as you can in the bike. And some people do it in the bike and they would replace the float bowl screws with Allen so they can get at them better. But I prefer to just put it all together, set it up on the bench. Everything's put together and the right side up. You'll put a hose on here and it'll put a gradual bend. And then as you fill up the carburetor properly, this float bowl will fill up. These things will do their job. They'll be sitting down like this. As they fill up like this, they'll close the needle valve, and then that stops the flow of fuel. Should stop the flow of fuel. And in the case of these carburetors, the fuel level will be right to the bowl. And you'll see that if you use a clear tube, you use a clear tube obviously, because you got to see the fuel, and you'll see the fuel moving in there, and it should be right there. If it's down, of course the floats are down too far. You'll need to make an adjustment, and you bend that pin, or you bend this part of the float right there. But it looks like it was right where it was, so I'm not too concerned about it. So gasket, all the gasket material was taken off, and this goes on here like so. Make sure I'm not missing anything. No parts. And again, these are not Phillips, and these were actually marked. So I don't know if you can see that or not, but there's a GIS dot right there. So yeah, when you put these in, again, these ones don't need to be torqued that hard either, because you're talking about a gasket that you're squeezing, and you're not trying to mate two pieces of metal together. And there's no structure, right? This is not a structural component. You're just trying to snug these screws up, and that is it. There's no need to put any more torque on them than that. And I'm not going to even torque these down as hard as I normally would either, because I may need to adjust the floats. But I'm sure, even though that's not torqued completely, still a little bit room to go, I'm still positive that that won't leak, because it's clean. They're new gaskets. And that's really all there is to it. I just know that. So I'm going to snug that guy up. Snug this guy up. Before I do anything, I'm going to have a look and make sure that that's the way this goes. Right side, right side. It is, in fact, the way it's supposed to go. Now, these things, gently, pull them back up. They're going to slide right into their spot. Spring, and then the cap. Now these caps, I have a photograph of how they came off, and I'm going to look at that photograph again, but that's the right, and this is the left, and I'm going to make sure that these go where they're supposed to go, right where they were before. I don't think there's a problem with them being in a different location. They are symmetrical, but I'm just not going to risk it. So the same thing with this one. It's going to go in, slide right down and orient itself. Spring goes in there, and then of course these caps are going to go on this one, was the left, this one was the right. And I know that this one goes that way because there's a scratches on it from the then go back in there like that. Be very gentle with these when you put them back together. Yeah, that's the way that goes. These screws were cleaned up also. One goes here, and there's other stuff I know that goes on here, but I just want to get this on. Just for now. All right, and this is why you take pictures. My phone. Okay, slowly but surely, we're getting this thing back together. There's a specific method for putting the choke back together. Keep everything on the right, that's the throttle cable right there. The choke actuator, the cable comes on the left side for the choke. So in keeping with all that, you've got a, this is the bracket for the throttle cable. Yeah, so that's got to go on there too. And I believe, if I look at my picture, yeah, it's got one of those. So I'll put that on now. Got one of those clips on it. Getting there. Okay, now the choke has to go on before we put that clip on because you can't get that cable across. You'd have to take it apart. And that's not going to happen, so oriented the proper way, short side on the right, longer side, which has the choke cable assembly on it. So I'm just going to put that there and put this here. And then I'm going to put the clip over that. Again, all the washers that have the extra, or all the screws that have that extra flat washer are for these cables. Cable holders. So they're going to go in like that. You can actually see the marks, scratch marks on it. So again, these things are just, they're not snug, they're not tightened up yet, but I'm just snugging them up just because I had to figure out the order of operation here. So, and figure out which screws are which, because some of them come with extra flat washers on them. So obviously the extra flat washers are for these little rings that hold fuel lines in place, and the vacuum line I think is over on this side of, yeah. And then the choke, of course, has to go on first before you can put this plate on. So there is a specific order of operation, and And of course it took me, I don't know, 15 minutes to figure it out, which way the choke went, which order it went on. So I'm gonna edit that out just so you can see how it goes back together. Like I said, take lots of pictures because you're gonna need them, and kind of take it from there. So the choke circuit, I'm not gonna bother with that because it's just me messing around with all the pins and the springs and all that stuff, and I'll work on that. So that's all I have left is the choke springs and the pins, and that's it. These things are together. These guys are working really nicely. They're very smooth, way smoother than what they used to be, and very clean. So when they go back in, they should look nicer too. All right, I'm gonna shut that off, and then when I get the springs for the choke all figured out, I'll come back. Okay, cut the camera off and messed around with the choke circuit a little bit just to make sure everything was working. Got it all together properly, looked at some photographs, got the pins in. The screws were actually quite easy. So again, if you've worked on the carburetor, right side, left side the whole time, short piece goes over here. That's where the throttle cable is going to go on the 1000, because it's only got a pull cable. Pin and the circlip, and both my circlips were distorted, so obviously they're not going back on. I picked this up. This is an absolute must, just like the O-ring kits. So that's that. And these are done. The choke circuit is really smooth. I'm really surprised. That was quite a change in how well that works. So with the cables, I got my throttle cable lubricated. I have the choke cable lubricated and reinstalled. And when this goes back in, like I said, pay particular attention to the seals, both up against the engine and the seal, the little short little tubes that go up into the frame. And that's where the air comes from. So that's it. And next step will be, I'll set up these. And of course I'm at 4,000 feet. And of course it, where I ride, it just goes up from there. And that's our actual altitude, physical altitude above sea level. But when you look at density altitude, you factor in air pressure and temperature. And oftentimes we're up at 6,000 feet. So I will make this a little bit leaner than spec, just because I know what needs to be done. And in fact, if I want better performance, I will probably end up swapping those jets out and going a little bit smaller, because up here, of course, the bike's going to be running pretty rich up here at the higher altitude, especially in the summertime. So I'll set these idles, or these pilot jets now. These are fuel jets. So like I said, as you turn them in, it restricts the fuel, so it makes it lean. And as you pull it out, adds fuel, so it makes it rich. So that's it. You don't want to bottom these out hard, because it's brass on aluminum. It might even be a brass fitting pushed in there. So just going to keep an eye on my alignment of my screwdriver here. And I'm going to go one turn out, and I'll go, let's see, 1.5. I'll start off with, should I have to go 2? Yeah, I'm going to go 2. So this one's, that's where it needs to be. So same thing. There's 1. And there's 2. And that's where they're going to stay. They're pretty much going to be set for now. And I'll leave those alone. Everything else seems to be set as per. Double check the, this is set. It is. Double check this one. It is. I'll go around and make sure all the nuts or all the screws are set up. So that's done now. And I'll, I might as well show you, bring it up a little bit closer, and you see how well that turned out. I'm gonna take some photographs too, so I can put these on my, post them if anybody needs to see photos. So all right. If anybody's doing this, I hope that helped.